Hi and welcome to ClickFix. This video will demonstrate how to configure ClickView and ClickSense in order to allow document links to be published to the ClickSense hub. First, we need to export new certificates from the ClickSense environment for the ClickView server in order to create a trust between servers. Make sure to add the FQDN of the ClickView Publisher server for machine name. Create the certificate password, check include secret key, also known as private key, and keep the Windows format and export the certificate. The certificates are stored in the local server location displayed. Copy the certificates over to the ClickView Publisher server. If you intend to use multiple publisher nodes, the same action needs to be performed on all intended nodes. Logged on as the ClickView Publisher service account, install the root certificate under the current user's Trusted Root Certificate Authority store. The client PFX certificate needs to be installed in the current user's personal store. Use the password created when exporting the certificate from ClickSense. Let the wizard automatically select the certificate store, which should place it in the personal store. Perform the same steps for the server PFX certificate. Now we can open the certificate snap-in with MMC and confirm that the Click Client and Server certificates were installed under the current user's personal store, with the private key included and the certificate path listed as valid. Next, we will configure the ClickView Distribution Service connection to the ClickSense QRS API in order to publish the document links. Open the Display Config file, and under the App Settings section, note the following entries which have to be manually added to the file. The QRS machine name value needs to match the FQDN used to connect to the ClickSense server. The next one needs to match either the machine name, FQDN, or alias record used by the ClickSense users to access the ClickView access point. The Sense Client Certificate thumbprint value indicates the Click Client Certificate to use for the trust. Retrieve it in the certificate under the Details tab from the thumbprint field. Use Ctrl-C for copying it and paste it in a text editor in order to remove the invisible non-Unicode character from the front of the string. Hit Backspace and Delete keys to make sure and then copy and paste it to the config file. The last entry, AJAX client path, only needs to be added in special occasions where the AJAX client path differs due to customizations. Save the file, then restart the distribution service. Next, we will configure ClickSense to allow shared content to be published. Create a new security rule with resource filter value as indicated. Check the Create Action permission. In order to allow all users indicated by ClickView Publisher task access to the shared document links, use the following string. Alternatively, an Active Directory security group can be referenced as shown, or a user directory shared by both ClickSense and ClickView environment as shown here. Now we are ready to create a publishing task. We can disable reload for this example, and under Distribute tab, add the ClickView server as recipient. Make sure to pick named users for user type, as it is the only supported option, and select the destination users. Next, we will tell the publisher service to publish to ClickSense by adding the Show in Sense Hub attribute under the Document Information tab as shown here. Make sure to set the value to true and click Apply. Check that the QVS server is selected on the ClickView web server, and now we can right-click the task and run. Check on the status and wait for it to complete. Then log on to ClickSense Hub and confirm that the new ClickView document section is now displayed and that the published document link works. In order to remove a link, you can either right-click Delete or remove the named user from the published task. Keep in mind that at least one user always needs to be named for the task to run successfully. Now we can run and wait for the task to complete, then check that the document link is removed from the ClickSense hub. And we're done.
If you would like more information, search for answers using the Unified Search tool on the support portal. It searches across the support knowledge base, Click Community, Click Help Site, and Click YouTube channels. Take advantage of the expertise of peers, product experts, and technical support engineers by asking a question in Click Product Forums on Click Community. And don't forget to subscribe to the support update blog. Thanks for watching. Nailed it.